Dear students, how are you all? I'm sure you all are doing great. Today we will learn and discuss some qualities of a good Muslim. As we are Muslims and we have some responsibilities and duties to follow in our daily life. As good Muslims, we must follow certain practices in our life. Some of these are given here. First of all, always obeys Allah. We are Muslims and we believe that Allah is the one and only. There is no other God except Allah. Allah is our maker and master. Allah can do whatever He wants to. He gives us life, He takes it away. He brings us back to life. He makes animals and plants to grow. Allah brings out the sun every morning. He brings night after each day. He makes the stars shine. Allah makes the wind blow and the rain fall. He makes the water flow from the mountains to the rivers and the seas. All these are the blessings of Allah for us. No one can do this except Allah. So in return, we must always thank Allah by obeying Him, by praying Him, and by loving Him. The other quality of a good Muslim is that he or she gets up early in the morning. Getting up early in the morning is a good habit because Islam teaches us the importance of time. All our prayers are said at times during the day and night. We get up early in the morning to say the Fajr prayers. Birds also gets up early in the morning and praise Allah in their own way. When we get up early in the morning, we feel fresh all day long and we can learn our lessons well. There is a famous saying in English, early to bed and early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. The other thing is that always tells the truth. It is a bad habit that you are lying to somebody for small things in your life. Children, our dear Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam hate liars. So try to speak truth in any situation of your life you are going through. A good Muslim always respects elders and cares for the young. You should follow some practices in your life that will be very helpful for you. For example, number one, we should spend time with them. We should be polite with them. Ask for advice, eat together, discuss family history and traditions, call them, tell them how much you respect and appreciate them, visit senior living communities. Dear students, if you have younger brothers and sisters at your home, now this is your responsibility to take care of them. We are Muslims and we have some responsibilities and duties to follow in our life. Like parents, we have parents at our home. Now it is our duty to give them respect, treat them with love, sit with them and try to spend some time with them because a good Muslim loves and cares for his or her parents. A good Muslim always obey their teachers and show some respect towards them. Dear students, teacher is like a role model for you. Use good manners with your teacher. Do not try to use bad language with them. It will be hurt them. Try to give the teacher your full attention. Follow the classroom rules and guidelines given by your teacher. Do your best to get to school and class on time. And in last, let your teacher know if you don't understand something or have a concern or a problem. Always tell your teacher. She or he will be there for you to solve your problems. If we have good neighbors or if we are good neighbors, that is a blessing for us. A good Muslim is always good to his or her neighbors. Having good neighbors is important because it makes our life in a neighborhood safer, happier and more fun. We also tend to have more peace of mind. Although we can choose our friends but not our neighbors, we must remember that we get what we give. Dear students, a good Muslim always greets others politely. A good Muslim always keeps his or her promises. Now, if you are greeting somebody, try to be polite with them with a big smile on your face and say Assalamu alaikum. If you promise somebody to help them if they are needy, now is your duty to fulfill your promise. A good Muslim never lie or use bad words. Now, this one is very important. Saying bad words to express your feelings or anger by using bad language, move away from them and do not use it yourself. If you hear somebody using bad language, try to stop them. A good Muslim is always mindful of doing things on time. Never waste time in useless things. Children, do not waste your time watching TV or playing games. Do your work at time. That will be very fruitful for you. A good Muslim does not fight over small things. Try to solve your problems in a good manner. Please don't argue. Stop doing that. You are going to be grounded. Remember, you will make things difficult for you. So please don't fight over small things. A good Muslim helps the weak and does not make fun of them. Dear students, this is the month of Ramadan. Search around you. There are lots of people who are needy. They want your help. Try to help them during this month or after this month. It will be very fruitful for you. And don't try to make fun of them because Allah don't like people who make fun of needy people or weak people. Dear students, always kind to animals because they are great creatures of Allah. They are so cute. They are companions. They love you as much as you love them. They make you feel important. They are like a friend. They do not talk back to you. They love unconditionally. They are always there for you whenever you need them. So try to kind with them. Dear students, these are some qualities of a good Muslim. Try to follow all these practices in your life. That will be very good for you. That will be very fruitful for you. Thank you.